the album titled All I Ask of You.
See you!
This is a pres un vere. Love singer team up aboard a cruise ship, the ensuing comedy can be best described.
We should have paired up years ago.
We're two of a kind, all right.
Partners?
Through thick or thin?
Night or day?
Right or wrong?
If you ever in town, here I am.
If you ever need a pal, I'm your gal.
If you ever get so happy you land in jail, I'm your bail.
It's friendship, friendship, just the perfect friendship.
Friendship, just the perfect friendship.
When other friendships have ceased to gel,
ours will still be swell.
Na 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 na.
Stay with me from the tools.
princes, yes, but wolves and humans too. Stay at home, I am home. Who out there could love you more than I? What out there that I cannot supply? Stay with me.
Based on Episcopal hymn number 138, We Plow the Fields and Scatter. And, you know, sometimes just a song of simple thanksgiving is just a really good thing. It also does help that when they rewrote the song for Godspell, they turned it into a slow rock ballad.
But it is fed and watered by God's
We are truly glad to be down with you. Next, despite its short-lived run on Broadway, Story of My Life, past a musical punch with a narrative storytelling in one of our favorites called The Butterfly, reminds us of the power that resides in each of us to change the world, no matter how insignificant.
In a far-off land, there lived a beautiful butterfly. In a kingdom full of blossom-covered trees. And winding through this paradise, a river danced along and played with the constant summer breeze. The butterfly found a tiny branch along the riverside and watched the river rushing who knows where. Carefully he sheltered from the power of the breeze, for surely it could toss him through the air. I'm a butterfly, he said, trivial and small, but in the greater scheme of things, I don't mean much at all. So I flap my wings to stretch myself and just enjoy the view. I'm a butterfly, what more can I do? One afternoon, the butterfly asked the river, Madam, what makes you hurry so? What splendid destination are you rippling toward? Where, oh, where do you go? The river said, I'm headed toward the ocean. And the ocean is a most amazing thing. I'm destination, hurrying along. Won't you join our friendly chase? I'm a butterfly, he said, trivial and small, and in the greater scheme of things, I don't mean much at all. So I flap my wings to stretch myself and just enjoy the view. I'm a butterfly, what more can I do? So the butterfly, he dreamed of the ocean. He longed to flutter high above the sea. But there are dangers in the sky for a tiny butterfly. So from his branch, he asked a question of the breeze. What makes you chase the river toward the ocean? Amazing thing. I'm simply made up of the currents in the air that start from the currents of your wing. Your tiny wing, you're a butterfly, my friend, powerful and strong, and I'm grateful for the way and the butterfly.
There are few characters in any genre more notable or noble than Don Quixote from the Broadway musical Man of La Mancha. Despite being ridiculed for his perpetual optimism in a cynical world, his moral clarity and vision to always see the good in people in even bad situations inspires us to fight for the right, reach for the unreachable star, and dream the impossible dream.
Used to sing all the time. He was an opera singer. by profession, and he had a big career over in Europe, and same with the American National Opera Company on the East Coast and things like that. He's the main one that taught me. He was 50 years older than I am. He was 50s when I was born, because I'm the youngest of 9 kids. And he taught at BYU and all that sort of thing. But when I was growing up, he had 3 heart attacks and was diabetic. And so he was kind of nearing the end of his life. And sometimes it was hard to connect with him. He spoke 3 languages fluently, and he was conversational, a couple others. But it felt like music was the one language that we could connect in. It was the one place where he and I could share something really special and beautiful. And as I continued to sing this song over the years after my father passed away and things like that, my husband really came to love this song. And so every time I would go perform at different places, you know, at church events or nursing homes or things like that, I would always sing this at the end of my concerts for him. And it just became this tradition. And so every concert you see, if I'm in charge of the program and it's me singing it, I will be ending with this song of Groundbird Singing, because that's, you know, what I do. So I'm going to sing it to my wonderful husband, and this is a Groundbird Singing.
Thank you.